Saturday, April 11th, 2009. Stage 2 share this. The messages on this site build on each other. For their full impact, read them in sequence, beginning with September 2008. They detail the situation on this planet, and our place in the universe as communicated to me. I hope, by presenting them to you, that they spark your curiosity. As always, I encourage you to seek your own unique truth. This is my 31st posting to Mark's Corner for 2009. The following is a message from Justine from the star system Altair, plus an important message from Brenton of Andromeda. Justine, thank you, Mark, for this opportunity to communicate with my brothers and sisters on Earth. The material you posted a few days ago was the perfect lead into what I wish to convey. The second stage of our transformation on Substem occurred when my fellow humans began to react to the truth that was coming forth, the truth about the lies, misdeeds, and actions of the powerful and wealthy, and about the existence of the dark energy and its agents. We had structures in which wealth could be concentrated in the hands of a few. We had structures in which power could be exercised by a few over the many. We had structures whereby truth had been withheld from the people. When the truth of how the people had been deceived for so many years began to seep into the consciousness of the populace, there were demonstrations, sit-ins, and acts of non-compliance all around the planet. One of the things we see that is different on your planet, particularly in America, is media coverage. People do not know that their fellow men and women are upset. This is being done purposely to keep you asleep. Now back to my story about Substem. Some of our actions were met with force, some were injured, and in some cases it was deadly. This only served to reinforce the determination of the people to see drastic change within our governments and other institutions. After several weeks, most governments were no longer able to function. My people went through a dark night of the soul, much as you, Mark, have done to arrive at the place where you are today. It was not a questioning of God. Rather, it was a questioning of traditional beliefs and structures. I would say to any of my brothers and sisters on Earth, do not shy away from confronting your dark side. It was only after we confronted the unpleasant truth that we were the ones who had allowed the darkness and iniquities to persist on our planet that we were able to move forward. On Substem, small groups of people banded together for their mutual survival. Those within these small bands helped each other in many ways, from supplying food to assisting with repairs to gardening. I look back on this second stage as the disintegration of all structures into a flat society with only these closely knit bands of people providing any form of organization. While some of these bands were rooted in fear, most eventually came to love as the path. Associated with this time was the failure of all services such as public utilities, law enforcement, fire protection, and garbage collection. It is not until one has to do without these that one appreciates the value of what one has. This second stage was not a pretty picture, and I am having trouble recalling some aspects of it. We foresee this stage occurring for you within the near future. However, on Substem we did not have the giant corporations you have on Earth, so our actions were targeted solely against our governments. Yours is a more complex situation, In many cases, you do not know who is responsible for what, or where to find them. So doing away with existing structures will be more difficult. Stage I was the unfolding of the truth about your enslavement. Stage 2 is the reaction of people to that realization. You are asking if this is necessary. My answer is yes. For many hundreds of thousands of years, you have been held in bondage. You, the slaves, have willingly submitted to the rule of the wealthy and powerful. It is not until you awaken and react to the beliefs and structures that bind you that any real change can occur. On Substem, many people clung to the old patterns, regardless of how undesirable they were, just because they were familiar. The wealthy and powerful on your planet have made provisions to hide from people's reactions, safe places where they can weather the storm. That was true on Substem also. I am relaying the dark days of turmoil on Substem, when the populace finally reacted to the truth of the dark energy to help you understand. Yes, there was initially anger. That soon changed into a realization that new ways had to emerge. That is stage 3, but first there is the stage of utter despair. The knowing that all has been a lie, and the collapse of beliefs and structures. Yes, beliefs also. People finally began to see that the beliefs that had buoyed them were false, and had led them into subservience. The most damaging were the religious beliefs that had separated them from God, and the leaders who had extracted tribute as they told them they were faulty. When these beliefs did not support us in our time of chaos, we finally discarded them. My experience on Substem was as a participant against the government and against my educational institution. You would probably see my institution as a college. I was a member of the teaching staff. My job was as a teacher of mathematics. When the truth came out, I was upset at the extent to which they had deceived me. At my college, we engaged in peaceful demonstrations, sit-ins, and acts of non-compliance. We refused to participate in violence. Our demands became so insistent that those in charge resigned. Also, I should say that on Substem the experiences were not uniform. Some regions let these actions, while other drilled. Some were violent, others were peaceful. The riots, demonstrations and sit-ins continued for several months, until the old no longer functioned. We gave little thought to reconstructing until all of the old ways, based on lies and misinformation, on omissions and secrets were gone.
Brenton, I was an observer at the time of Substem's transformation, much as I am now. My role at that time was to help identify those individuals who were active in the process of change. My task is similar at this time. While most people are unconscious, some like to know what is happening around them. They attend lectures and read books, but their personal lives are largely unaffected. Those who would remain on Earth as the caretakers will be people of action. It is by acting that you make your choice known. The actions to which I refer need not take the form that Justine has related, although they may. It can be something as simple as turning one's back on the current paradigm. It can be as private as forcefully directing one's energy to the momentum of change. If you use your imagination, you will find many ways to act in the interests of transformation. But act you must. Choose you must. We who are of the Armada are awaiting your actions before coming to assist you. The bifurcation of humanity will be determined.